maintenant mon bon ma naijulikane dunia ni kote.
Ni kweli lilo ambalo Mungu ameahidi maishani mwetu litatimia. Ijapokuwa alivyosema ilitatimia, haimaanishi shetani hata jaribu kuinuka. Wakati kama huu nataka twende mbele za Mungu, ukasimame dhidi ya yale maovu yote, yeyote yule mshirikina, mganga, uchawi, shetani, miungu, aina yote ya uovu iliyoinuka kusimama kupinga hatima yetu. Mwaka huu tumeambiwa ni mwaka wa Shekaina. Mungu wetu aliloahidi atatimia. Lakini kama Danieli, inaweza kuwa Mungu aliyemtuma amezuiliwa na mkuu wa Pasha. Siku ya leo simama katika zamu kwa jina la Yesu, kwa ajili ya maisha yako, kwa ajili ya familia yako, kwa ajili ya watu wako, kwa ajili ya lile Mungu aliloahidi maishani mwako. Simama na ukajisimamishe katika jina la Yesu, kinyume na yeyote aliyesimama kupinga lile Mungu alilotuma litimie maishani mwetu katika jina la Yesu. Ee Mwokozi Yesu, tunaamini uliloahidi litatimia. Tunaamini ulilopanga maishani mwetu limetimia. Ulilokusudia Bwana, uliloandika Jehova Mungu, ninayo hakika, ninayo imani ulilosema litatimia. Lakini Baba, tunajua muovu amesimama kutupinga sisi watu wako, kusimama katika maisha yetu kutudhibiti. Ee Mwokozi Yesu, tunasimama kwa jina lako, jina ambalo lililokuwa kuu kuliko majina yoyote yale. Jina, kwa jina la Yesu kila goti litapiga, kwa jina la Yesu kila ulimi litakiri kwamba wewe ni Mungu, kwa jina la Yesu, jina lililokuwa kuu kuliko majina yetu, katika majina yote. Ee Mwokozi Yesu, tunayo haki kwamba wewe Bwana ndiye mwokozi wetu, wewe ndiye uliotupigania. Siku ya leo Jehova, kwa thibitisho ya neno lako kwamba wewe uliloahidi, wewe si mwanadamu udanganye, wewe si mwana wala mwanadamu kwamba uhitaji kutubu. Ee Mwokozi Yesu, ninayo imani kwa nilo kusudia maishani mwangu, lakini muovu amejaribu kuinuka kunipinga kwa njia nyingi. But because Lord I know, because you are the King of Kings, you are lifted above every principality, above every might, above every spirit, above every rulers of darkness. You are highly lifted up, my Lord Jesus. And because you are my Lord, I arise in your name. I arise in your name, the name that you have given me, Lord Jesus. Your name, Lord Jesus. I stand against that enemy who is withholding that which is mine, who is resisting that which is mine. In the name of Jesus, I declare this year will not end before the word of God is true in my life. Before the word of God, that which was for this year has been accepted, has been magnified, has been manifested in my life. Oh God and my Lord, I stand to resist the devil. I stand to resist his devices in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord my God, I stand to declare that which he has said is nullified by your blood. Lord Jesus, you have said that everything that was done, it is nullified by your sacrifice, oh God, by your sacrifice, Lord Jesus, your death and resurrection. Oh my Lord and my God, the power of resurrection, I call upon the power of resurrection, that you may restore, you may resurrect in the name of Jesus. Oh my God and my Lord, I cry, restore, restore that which was bound in prison, restore those who are bound in prison, restore my God, restore that which was stolen from me. Oh you devil, the word of God says, if the enemy, if the thief is found, he must return sevenfold that which he stole. In the name of Jesus, na kuamuru wewe muovu ulioiba kilicho kilichokuwa chango na kuamururudishe katika jina la Yesu. Miaka niliyopoteza na kuamururudishe kwa jina la Yesu. Rakashaya bazaya kuzuia ulikofanya na kuamuru achilie kwa jina la Yesu. Kilichokuwa chango na kuamuru achilie kwa jina la Yesu. Kilichokuwa cha mume wangu na kuamuru achilie kwa jina la Yesu. Kilichokuwa cha watoto wangu na kuamuru achilie kwa jina la Yesu. Kilichokuwa cha nyumba yangu na kuamuru achilie kwa jina la Yesu. Oh, rakasha ya bazaya. Shikili ambacho ni cha hatima yangu. Wewe mwovu uliyoshikilia, wewe mwizi umepatikana na umeshikwa kwa jina la Yesu. Achilia, achilia, achilia. Oh, we call upon the power of the resurrection. It is the power that was able to raise Jesus from the dead. That was by the Spirit of the God, the Spirit of the Most High. We call upon you, Spirit of the Most High. Oh, Holy Spirit, come and bring your freedom. Holy Spirit, oh, rikasha ya bazaya, rikasha da bazaya. Spirit of the Most High, you are in us. And the word of God says that the Spirit that was able to raise Jesus from the dead is the Spirit that is in us. In the name of Jesus, roho huo ufufuo, oh, katika jina la Yesu, na kusie roho wa Bwana, enda ukafufue kilichokufa maishani mwangu, katika jina la Yesu, kafufue kilichokufa kwa hatima yangu, katika jina la Yesu. Oh, Roho Mtakatifu, kafufue kilichokufa kwa familia yangu, fufua kilichokufa katika kanisa la Faith Celebration Ministry, katika jina la Yesu. We call upon you, Spirit of the Most High. We ask for the resurrection power in our lives, oh God. We ask for the restoration power in the name of Jesus. Let Shekinah glory be manifest in our life. Let it become a reality in our families, in our jobs, in our businesses, in our accounts, in our shambas, in the name of Jesus. And now, Lord, let us go before the Lord and pray for Kenya, remembering the next year is going to be a year of election in the name of Jesus. Father, we commit our nation before you. We commit our leaders before you. Oh, Spirit of the Most High, it is you who select who shall be the ruler in the name of Jesus. We ask for godly leaders in the name of Jesus. We ask you, Jehovah Father, for leaders that fear you, for the spirit of the fear of the Lord upon every leader, upon every leader in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord Jesus, the Spirit of the Most High, it is you who spreads and gives even the other spiritual Lord. Even in your word of Isaiah, Jesus, the spirit of fear was on you. The fear of the Lord. May the spirit of the fear of the Lord come upon us. Let the spirit of the fear of the Lord come upon our nation. In the name of Jesus. That the leaders will walk in, oh Lord, in fear of you, our Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let that corrupt spirit be defeated in Jesus' name. Be nullified in Jesus' name. We bring you down. Oh, you spirit of serpent. We bring you down in the name of Jesus. We crush your head in the name of Jesus. We crush your head in the name of Jesus. Oh, Rakazakayaba. Lord, in your word you have said that we shall crush the head of the serpent. Rakazakayaba Zaya. In the name of Jesus. Yakozakaraba Zaya. Rikozoko Yaba Zaya.
You yourself, Lord. Not what?
Oh, our Lord and our King, that which you have promised, you shall make it true. You shall make it true. We count you faithful. We count you faithful. We count you faithful for our nation. We count you faithful in the name of Jesus. Father, at the edges of our nation, may you put a hedge of fire. May you protect our nation. May you protect our leaders in the name of Jesus. May you protect, oh God, the governors in the name of Jesus. May you protect the legislature. May you protect the judiciary. Oh Lord, our God, we ask you in the name of Jesus to surround our nation, oh Lord, with your angels in the name of Jesus. The Lord told the Israelites that he shall send an angel before them. He shall send hornets who will go forth and deal with every nation that was to stand against the Israelites. May you go before the Lord now and be a Mungu atume huyo malaika anaifa kwenda mbele yako kusawazisha njia zako kutengeneza njia zako. Baba tunakusii siku ya leo, maana wewe ndiye Mungu mkuu wa wakuu wote, maana neno lako limesema kwamba tukikuomba utasikia. Siku ya leo Jehova tunaomba utume malaika wako anaye uliyemtuma anayefa kwenda mbele zetu Bwana katika jina la Yesu, akapigane na waovu wetu, akapigane na waovu wetu katika jina la Yesu. Baba tuma malaika wako, Baba tuma malaika wako. Lord, may you send the hornets, let them go before us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Even in 2021, let the angel go before us to make sure there is peace in our nation, to make sure there is peace in our nation, in the name of Jesus, Father. Oh, Rika Shada Messiah, you are the same God yesterday, today, and forever. We ask for that angel who shall make our work easier, who shall make our possession easier. Lord, you have said and you have promised that we shall enter into the land of milk and honey, where, Lord, there shall be no sickness. In the land where we shall possess vineyards, we did not build. In the land we shall own houses, we did not build. Our King and our God, in the name of Jesus, we ask you to send that angel. We ask you to send those hornets in the name of Jesus. Rakashaya Zaya, deal with every enemy. Bwana, pigana na watetezi wetu. Bwana, pigana wanaoteta nasi. Teta na wanaoteta nasi. Katika jina la Yesu. Mwokozi Yesu, tunaomba Bwana, tunaomba uwepo wako uende nasi. Ewe Bwana wa majeshi, tusikie. Kama uendi nasi, hatutaki kutoka hapa. Hatuwezi peke yetu, enda nasi. Tuwatua shingo ngumu, tusamehe. Hatufai mbele zako, turehemu. Twalilia e Bwana, utukufu na uso wako. Bila wewe tutashindwa, enda nasi. Tutavua mapambo yetu, vitu vyote vya thamani kwetu. Tutavua mapambo yetu, vitu vyote vya thamani kwetu.
Mioyo
yetu,
mioyo
yetu, twale. Na utembe nasi.
Tutakase,
tutakase. Na utembe nasi.
Yesu tutakase,
tutakase. Na utembe nasi.
Tutakase, na utembe nasi.
Asante Yesu, maana upamoja nasi, upamoja nami, upamoja nasi wakati huu. Tunarudisha shukrani mbele zako kwa umbali uliotupeleka jioni ya leo. Tunakuomba mwokozi Yesu, kuwe pamoja nasi, takasa mioyo yetu. Tunapoleta sifa mbele zako, tunaomba Bwana ukazipokee, ukatuongoze, ukituingiza katika uwepo wako Bwana. Pokea sifa na utukufu, maana hakuna mwingine kama wewe. Ni katika jina la Yesu tumeomba jioni ya leo. Amina. Shangwe na vigelegele kwa Yesu. Tunaweza kusimama, tukaweze kumwimbia Bwana, tukalisifu jina lake, tukamchezea Yesu. Hallelujah. Nani kama wewe? Yeah. Sifa hizi zote ni zako. 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 Oh, sifa hizi zote ni zako. 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 Yesu.
Sifa hizi zote ni zako. Sifa hizi zote ni zako.
Wapendeza Bwana, wapendeza. Wapendeza Yawe, wapendeza. Sijaona mwingine kama wewe. Sijaona mwingine kama wewe.
Wapendeza Bwana, wapendeza.
Wapendeza
Bwana, wapendeza.
Sijaona
mwingine kama wewe.
Yesu.
Sijaona mwingine kama wewe.
Wainua Yawe, wainua. Wainua jire, wainua. Sijaona mwingine kama wewe. Sijaona mwingine kama wewe.
Wainua Bwana, wainua.
Yesu.
Wainua Bwana, wainua. Sijaona mwingine kama wewe.
Yesu.
Sijaona mwingine kama wewe.
Ndio, ndio, ndio Bwana. Tunakurudishia utukufu wote Bwana.
Ndio, ndio Bwana. Tunakurudishia utukufu wote Bwana.
Ndio, ndio, ndio Jire. Tunakurudishia utukufu wote Bwana.
Ndio, ndio, ndio Bwana. Tunakurudishia utukufu wote Bwana.
Ndio, ndio, ndio Shama. Tunakurudishia utukufu wote Bwana.
Ndio, ndio, ndio Bwana. Tunakurudishia utukufu wote Bwana.
Inua Yesu, inua. Inua Yesu, inua.
Inua
Yesu, inua. Inua Yesu, inua.
Inua
Yesu, inua. Inua Yesu, inua. Bariki Yesu, bariki.
Bariki
Yesu, bariki.
Bariki
Yesu, bariki.
Bariki
Yesu, bariki. Utukufu kwake Yesu. Hallelujah. Utukufu kwako Yesu. Hallelujah.
Utukufu kwako Yesu.
Hallelujah. Utukufu kwako Yesu.
Hallelujah.
Utukufu kwako Yesu. Bwana wa majeshi, utukufu kwako Yesu. Hallelujah.
Utukufu kwako Yesu.
Hallelujah.
Utukufu kwako Yesu. Hallelujah.
Wewe munene ngai. Wewe munene. Wewe munene ngai. Wewe munene. Wewe munene ngai. Wewe munene. Hallelujah ngai. Wewe munene.
Wewe munene ngai.
Wewe
munene. Wewe munene ngai.
Ngai.
Wewe munene. Wewe munene ngai. Wewe munene. Hallelujah ngai. Wewe munene.
Oh, wambarario Jesu. Wako wambarario.
Wambarario Jesu. Wambarario Jesu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah Jesu. Wambarario.
Oh, rockero Jesu. Oh, rockero.
Rockero Jesu.
Jesu.
Rockero. Nogero Jesu. Nogero. Hallelujah Jesu.
Nogero.
Ngai wa kwa ngai wa kwa e.
Ngai wa kwa we wa mage ngai.
Hallelujah.
Ngai wa kwa ngai wa kwa e. Ngai wa kwa we wa mage
ngai. Ngai wa kwa ngai wa kwa
ngai wa kwa e. Jesus.
You can be seated as our pastor comes. Pastor Muria, come and give us the word that God has put in his heart that we may be fed. Amen. Karibu.
Thank God for every one of us that is here this evening. You have sacrificed your energy. You have sacrificed your resources. You have sacrificed your time so as to be here this hour. And may good Lord bless you. Brethren from Udiro, thank you for coming. Brethren from Chogoria, I really thank God for you for making it or for purposing to be here at this hour. Otherwise, I thank God for giving us yet this opportunity just but to hear from him. And whenever you are given time by God, he gives it to us so as to utilize it in his own plan and never in our plan, in order to accomplish the purpose that he sent us in this world for. Today, I thank God for the word. I was being tempted to go to the very message on truth, that is true happiness, which is a very long topic. Remember that last time we only shared 3/4 of the past, that is of the first part of it, that is of the first part of it, that is on the Holy Spirit, that is on the Spirit, that is the poor in the Spirit. But then we are not going to go to it, but I was led to this topic, that is tree and eggs fruit. Tree and eggs fruit. This is the word that is found in Matthew 7, verses number 15, from verses number 15. It can also be found in other gospels, like it can be found in Matthew, that is in Mark, and some other parts of Matthew. But then we are concentrating in this Matthew from verses number 15. Come again. 7:15 from verses number 7, number 15. Is it raining? Let me see. Good. Now, this is a very familiar topic. Topic that is very common in our churches, in our fellowships, and in quite a number of believers gathering. And the topic is, that is tree and its fruit. Now, verses number 15 leads. Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly are ravenous wolves. Now, there is this word, beware. Beware. It's a caution. Just that this is something that you are supposed to take care of every time as a believer. Now that this is not specifically stated where to beware, it tells us we are supposed to be cautious at all time, or to beware, or to be prepared, or to set ourselves ready, or be cautious at all time. And after that, he talk about false prophets, false prophets, false prophets. Who are these false prophets? These are those that call themselves prophets, but then their outward, or what comes from them, or their action does not portray a true prophet. These are people that at times cannot be known by their outward appearance. There are people that are from outside you find to be very okay, to be people that are well in spirit, people that talk very well at times, although not all the time, people that are very confusing, that I can put it. Why confusing? Because when you hear that somebody is dressed like a sheep, that is in a goat, then it means that there is a wound that is being what? Covered. There is something that is being covered from inside. And I can only call it a wound, kidonda. Although not the Bible that is saying that. But then I can call it what? A kidonda. Ambacho kinaweza kuambukizwa kutoka moja na mwingine. Or disease that can be transmitted from one person to another. Or disease that is contagious. And disease that is notifiable. And disease. And that's why we are taught to be cautious about such character. Because we may not tell them from outward what appearance. And at times you can find ourselves having been infected by the very disease. Because we cannot tell easily on whether this is the kind of disease that is in this world, in this character. Not until we stay for a while and then try and learn from what it's being produced, or which is what is getting, that is what we get from such. Where do we find such character? They are all over. They are in our homes. They are in our schools. They are in at our working places. They are in our churches today. In that, they are all over. They are all over. You can also find them not only in general church, but you can also find them right at the altar where sacrifices are done. They are all over. They are all over. And of course, the very notorious ones and the very dangerous ones are those that are found at the altar of God. Because such as confused many. In other words, we can say the kind of skin they have put on is well disguised, in that you cannot know about them that easy. And that's why we have a lot of danger in the church today. That's why we have a lot of problem, in that for people to come to Christ, it is just by taking the hand of God. Because of that prophet that is found in sheep's womb and then is found at the what? At the heart of God. The one that is supposed to show the way, but dressed in skin of sheep. The one that is supposed to direct the congregation, but in wolf's what? The world that we've had in our media today is full. That is, our media today is full of that word, this word, this character. You've had many people wasting their resources in the name of this kind of prophet. In the name of Sendiki to this and the other. In the name of Utabarikiwa. In this and the other is going to happen. Beware, that's the word. Beware. Just that whenever outside, that is, whatever step you intend to take, you need to take the first word. Beware. When you hear them say this and the other, beware of false prophets. Beware means that they are those that are lied to the God or through what? Prophets. For those one, we are okay. They are talking about sheep what? Sheep's skin. Why are they not talking about God's skin? Why are they not talking about skin of wickedness? Why are they not talking about hypocrisy skin? But sheepskin. Why? They know that is after you who are, that is, these people are after those that are devoted their lives to Christ. Know this, they are after those, mainly those that are devoted their lives to Christ Jesus. Because these are the ones that intend to confuse. Because they know they are the one that can hearken to their words easily. Know that they are not after the others, but then they mostly after those that are in the house of God. And that's why they want to display kind of godliness that is not. Why do you hear somebody being told to disguise him or herself to be a sick person? So that you can win many, and so that many believers can come your way. They know that believers at time have led to a standard whereby not until one has been clouded with the word, then that can be snatched very easily. And there are those that can be snatched easily. They know that when they have won such character or such believers, they have won or they intend to win. Because they know if they win that one that is devoted the one, first, that character is going to attract more of that nature, of more of those who have devoted their lives to Christ. And these ones are the ones that have known the secret of godliness. In that when this godliness is brought close to them, then they have won the battle. They are bent on devouring the flock for their own word ends. Devouring, kodokia, queer. They are eager to get food from this world, the sheep. They are eager to get satisfaction from this world, sheep. They are set to satisfy their gratification from these sheep. And they put themselves before sound gospel or sound word doctrine. And then they bring about their own doctrine, which appears like what? The true doctrine. Let's go to this sheep. What is a sheep? The sheep is an emblem or a symbolic of innocence. Are we there? It's a symbolic of what? Innocence. And when we talk about innocence, we talk of that character of a what? Of a believer. You know, believers are very innocent. True believers are very innocent. Imagine. You know, this one reminded me about this in Itwanini. Pyramid scheme. Ilikuja na nini na front people watu wa bere hapo wa altar. Most of those people. Leading men to lose their world, their money. Because believers are innocent. Mean God help us in anu. Mean God help us. Yeah, mean God help us, Jamani. Ili to support in our world, in your innocence. They are sincere. They are sincere. Believers are sincere. Or sheep is what? Sincere to itself. Believers are also sincere. Sheep is harmless. Imagine a believer. Thank you. Yani, ukiwapiga unaona kama tu unakuwa asante. A true believer. Unam chalaba, unam chapa, unasema, thank you. Some of the ACC, they are refugees from what? From Onai. Innocence. Imagine Kondo. Ikesema siendi ayendi. Yeah. I'm reminded of the time that I used to graze. And then they were rained on. It was hard to make them move. It was not easy. And this is the character in true believers, Jamin. They are harmless. And these are the words that these false prophets are coming after. These who have dressed like true what? True disciples of Christ. But dressed in a coat or skin of a what? Of a sheep. They come in sheep's clothing. To come in sheep's clothing is to assume the appearance of sanctity. Hear this. To come in sheep's clothing is to assume the appearance of sanctity or ori, being ori. hapa niko sawa. Ai hapa kila mtu akiniona akinisikia atajua mambo ni sawa. Hata maombi yangu nita change my style of word prayers. Kama nilikuwa naomba kwa hiyo sauti ni sauti nitafanya nini? Nita change. Hata nitasema praise God nyingi sana diposa hiyo ati kuna ungu sana hapo. Hata kama mambo ya kuruka na shiru na kuruka, nitajaribu niruke, ndiposa, ni when one. At least one. In my word, in my hypocrisy. Clothing, she's clothing, is to assume their holiness. Hii jameni, hapa, kanisani, hata sina ni, nitakuwa nikienda kwa njia taratibu. Hata mikono nikiweka hivi. Are together? Ukinisalimia. Arapu. Nasema nini? Asante sana. Nita assume the law of holiness and innocence. This what clothing? Law of what? Holiness and innocence. But see, the problem is, well, the heart is what? Is evil. But then appearance is innocence, holiness. But the heart is evil. Imagine. Mungu help us. Eti. Hey, watch out, even in December, you're even in Daniel. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, teachers who preach for hire. These are people who preach for what? For hire. Having no motive to enter into the ministry, but to get a living. Hear this. Yeah, you are in the ministry, but you are not called in the ministry. Are you there? You are not called in the ministry, but then you are here because you are going to get a living from the ministry. So many, and that's why there is distortion of the word of God. Because you are where you are not supposed to be. I'm sorry to say this. Because of one character. Ordained, leveraged, very senior. Na anaenda kuambia wala anobilia. Hey, Biblia ni mzitu mkubwa. Mtu anaja kupotelea kwa haraka sana. Yani, na at the end of the month, anaenda kupata nini? Msahala. Not after the sheep. Not after those that is shepherding. But after his own word, greedy. After his own word, satisfaction. After his own word, fulfillment. False prophet. Imagine, this reminds me. Help me to say this. I would have loved. You know, there's this thing. Remain in the mother church. Kule nizaliwa. Hear this. But then there is this thing. You know, I will ask two questions to the people that were supposed to give me true answer. But then when I listen to the answer that I got, these were just leading me astray. And after this answer, I did my about turn. And went through King for a place that I can settle. And that's why I'm here today. Are we together? This is not the same. When I was a youth, those are the time that I was what? A youth. But then the gospel that I used to get. Ya kwamba, I'm doing this. This is done to satisfy those that are with you on Sunday. I think you can attest this one when you are looking about baptism. Whereby somebody is not baptized in the right way because of honor that is being given to the same. That you are going to put this person to shame if at all we do the right baptism to him. Yani huyo mtu mkubwa hivi tajiri yote tumtumbukize kwa maji. Hapana. Utakuwa tuki we are tampering with this word. Heshima. Huyo ni mheshimiwa. Atakikani kuingizwa kwa nini? Kwa maji. Huyo anatakiwa kuweka tumaji kidogo hapa na cross hapa kidogo na ambiwe tumebatizwa, umebatizwa. Na watoto wake wakija pia waambiwe wamebatizwa wakiwa watoto. Hiyo yote. Sababu we want to keep dignity of this word. About to be biblical dignity, ikae kando. Na wewe kama ni yoda, pana wewe, unajua mimi ndio leverage, au mimi ndio mimi, na pesa ni mimi nitapata. All together, nimeaziriwa mimi. Kwa hivyo, don't make a mistake of teaching a different gospel, apart from what you have heard from me. All together. Baptizing evil with the truth. Hello? Code. Maybe. By the way, there is a time that is, of course, that's a way to cause, that is where they go to an living. So this one gives us a warning impression that you are there just for honey. And this, of course, gives us a situation that's very worth worrying. You know, when you are going there for earning, you cannot do the right thing. You can never do the right thing when you are there for earning. Because you can never come here evil.
Allah.
You cannot rebuke evil. Because you know, if I rebuke that tajiri, msala wako utatoka wapi? Kwa hivyo nebri, hebu ni kimi, hata kama naona hiyo inaendelea mbaya. It's okay. That's why he, hallelujah, may God help us. Ati mtu akija hapo apaki vieite hapo nje. Hata kama ametoka kazi yake ni mbaya, hiyo ndiyo atafanywa ni chairperson of the church. Ndiyo atafanywa financial manager of the church. Jiatafanya spokesman of the church. Jiatafanya everything. Na kama yu jamaza ata toa sauti, nothing is done in that church. Because we have entertained falsehood in the house of God other than the truthfulness of the kingdom of God. May God help us. Well, now, pastor, unakaji, unakama toa. However, there may be a grave. You know, at times there may be that grave of what? Innocence. Growth of what? Innocence. Of course, they have, at times you see that growth of innocence in them, okay? Useful sheep, the true pastors, commissioned by God, or whatever name, class or party they may belong. In the sight of what? Touching God, no other leaven us. Will serve me not to talk much about this thing. Now the question is, why are our youths leaving schools, colleges at a tender age? Who are these leading them to come out of this institution when it's not their time to leave those institutions? Why is it that we hear some of this news in the media? We are the so-called prophet of God are concerned about some of these and are tricking in the house of God. We need to turn around and beware, as we say. Why do we have some cases of the very servants who ought to be taking charge over the flock turn their back on the very sheep? Why? It's because some are put on this kind of what? Skin. They have turned from true gospel. And they have gone away from what they are supposed to be doing. And are now in destroying the very sheep or the very sheep that are supposed to take charge of, or the very congregation that are supposed to take charge of. What does that is Matthew 24 verses 11 says? And many false prophets will arise and lead many astray. Many false prophets will arise. Know the word is saying, the Bible is talking about what? Many false prophets. So they are not few. They are not what? Few. They are many. No wonder they beware. Pray that I don't know how we live, or how we display ourselves outside there, how we display ourselves in our churches, knowing that they are all over. And that's why the Bible is talking about it, many, many false word prophets. And many means many. It's not talking about few. So it means that in a church, they are not few, but they are many. Allah. In the world, there are many false prophets. There are many. That's why there is always fights all over. You hear somebody is a pastor, is a laborer or so, but is fighting another church somewhere. He or she is praying against what? Church, another church what? Within or somewhere. He's praying against a believer, another believer. He's praying against another what? Pastor. Then, what is this? If not false prophets, they are all over. And of course, if at all I am a pastor and I'm praying against Pastor Skuku, then the people that I'm leading are going to follow suit, because that is me leading them. So they become false prophets because of their pastor who has become a what? A false prophet. Are we there? In that we become what? Actors. Instead of becoming what? True believers of God. Yes. That is Mark 13:22. For false Christ and a false prophet. Hear this. False Christ. Oh, I'm finished winding up. For false Christ. Hear this. False Christ. Hear the Christ. In other words, you know what they talk about Christ? Christ-like. All together. Christ. False Christ. It tells me that there are people that are going to do what Christ used to do. They are going to come. They are coming, doing that which is seen, like it is being done by who? By Christ himself. But this is not. See, we will analyze. And it's so great signs. Hear this. And it's so great what? Signs and wonders. So as to lead astray, if possible, even the elect. If elect are going to be led astray, then it means that these signs are unique. These signs that are shown by these are peculiar. The signs that are seen, that are done by these, are special. If at all they are going to lead them astray. Na huyu anakaa kama Yesu mwenyewe jameni. Angalia bila, imagine anaombea kila mtu. Ndiyo sababu some of them have given themselves name of Christ. Yeah, I went to that cruise and I healed everybody. Everyone that came, I used the same. Nilimponya. Are you together? Oh, ni mimi peke yangu ni mimi kusikia hiyo. Niliponya wote wale kuja hapo. Na hiyo ni ati nitoka hiyo ni kusema mbele ya watu wengi. May God help us. Hebu ni sema, hebu ni siende sana. Eh, na hii kitu nayo. Just kuna akuna tena. Praise the Lord. Pastor Sikuku. Pastor Sikuku.
Sifiwe, hebu tushike sadaka zetu mkononi. Sitaki kuongea mengi kwa sababu naona masaa yanatusukuma. Na najua wengi wangependa kufika nyumbani washughulikie mambo jambo moja mbili tatu. Bwana asifiwe. Kwa hivyo tushike sadaka zetu. Lakini hiyo inaitwa tahadhari. Beware, hiyo ni tahadhari kwa Kiswahili. Ebu, tuichukulie maanani. Sababu, wakati unatahadharishwa, inaonekana kunaweza kukatokea hatari mahali. Sindio? So that, we don't just believe, you know, everyone saying, Jesus. Kuna wengine wanasema Yesu, lakini wamevalia ngozi ya? Kondoo, na ni mbweha. Kicheza watakukaba ngangu. Amen. Hey, so kwanza nyakati za sasa ndio mbaya sana. We are in dangerous times. We are in dangerous time. Shike sadaka zetu. Shike sadaka zetu. Tuweze kumtolea Bwana. Tuombe. Our Father and our God, we thank you. This evening, Lord, you've spoken to us. Even, O Lord, concerning the caution of the false prophets. We know your word says very well that we be, O God, discernful to know what the Spirit is operating. Because the spirit of the Antichrist has been released. And my Father and my God, we pray that you'll give us that very quick discernment so that we'll not fall a prey to those that are out, even, Father, on the causeway of the devil. I want to thank you for your children, for sparing time to be in your presence. Thank you, Father, that you're going to manifest yourself upon them to do them good. Thank you for your servant who has ministered unto us. We pray that you will continue to grant us, to grant him revelations, that as we gather and, oh God, listen to the word of God, it shall find a place in our hearts. It will change us and transform us. We thank you for the entire church, even those that have not been able to come. Remember them, oh God. Those that are held up in other businesses, we pray that, Father, your spirit will continue to minister unto them. As we go home, go with us, my Father, protect us and preserve us against any accidents. As we give, accept us. Accept our sacrifices that we bring at your altar. And Lord, cause the spirit of struggling to be broken. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit with us now and forevermore. Amen. Turudia mutindo ya mask, eh? Sawa sawa. Mask. Kuna Omicron, sijui Omicron, Omicron. Ambayo iligundulikana.